I invite you to stand as you're able. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who forgives all our sin and whose mercy endures forever.
Amen.
God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit, that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Gracious God, have mercy on us. We confess that we have turned from you and given ourselves into the power of sin. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things we have done and things we have failed to do. Turn us again to you and uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. God, who is rich in mercy, loved us even when we were dead in sin, and made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. In the name of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. Almighty God, strengthen you with power through the Holy Spirit, that Christ may live in your hearts through faith. Amen. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Mercy on us, Lord, and hear our solemn prayer. We come to hear your living word. It saves us from despair. Have mercy on us, Christ, and wash away our sin. Pour out your grace and make us whole, that new life may begin. Have mercy on us, Lord. Make sin and shame depart. Renew us with your saving power. Create in us new hearts.
Thank you.
Source and sustainer of life, we cherish the myriad works of your hands. Water, earth, and sky are yours, as are all their inhabitants, wild and tame. We thank you for creatures that nourish and serve us, befriend, enrich, entertain, and protect us. May we who are made in your image care for them well, and may your groaning yet wondrous creation rally and thrive, revealing to all who come after us your wise, redemptive, transfiguring love, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Amen. Let us all pray together. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is error, the truth. Where there is doubt, the faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes.
Very good, thank you. The psalm for this morning is Psalm 8. My copy doesn't have highlighted verses versus regular verses, so I'll just start out with verse number 1, and we'll alternate, so I'll be reading the odd-numbered ones, and you can follow with the even-numbered verses. O Lord, our sovereign, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens.
Out of the mouths of babes and infants, you have founded the bulwark because of your foes, the silence, the enemy, and the avenger.
When I look at your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars that you have established.
What are human beings that you are mindful of them, mortals that you care for them?
Yet you have made them a little lower than God, and crowned them with glory and honor.
You have given them dominion over the works of your hands. You have put all things under their feet.
All sheep and oxen, and also the beasts of the field.
The birds of the air, and the fish of the sea, whatever passes along the paths of the sea.
O Lord, our sovereign, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
Hallelujah, Lord and Savior, open now your saving word. Let it burn like fire within us. Speak until our hearts are stirred. Alleluia, Lord, we sing for the good news that you bring. The Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
He said to his disciples, therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat, or about your body, what you will wear. For life is more than food, and the body more than clothing. Consider the ravens. They neither sow nor reap. They have neither storehouse nor barn, and yet God feeds them. Of how much more value are you than the birds? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your span of life? If then you are not able to do so small a thing as that, why do you worry about the rest? Consider the lilies, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. And yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today, and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, how much more will he clothe you, you of little faith? And do not keep striving for what you are to eat and what you are to drink, and do not keep worrying, for it is the nations of the world that strive after all these things. And your Father knows that you need them. Instead, strive for his kingdom, and these things will be given to you as well. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. Beloved, grace and peace be unto you from our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. Amen. It seems a little funny that we've arrived at this week in 2020 with Jesus telling us not to worry about anything. There's at least a few things that I'm worried about. Is anybody out there worried about anything? Yeah. And yet he reminds them, his own closest followers, that all the energy we can pour into worry accomplishes nothing. Nothing. We can't worry ourselves into better health. We cannot worry ourselves into a new job. We cannot worry ourselves into finding the right house. And we cannot worry ourselves out of all of our troubles. If anything, our own worry and anxiety only adds to whatever troubles are already present, and it magnifies them. And in this sense, I try to take, whenever I can, a cue from my own dog, who every day wakes up and bounds out of his crate. And he's getting to be a senior citizen now, you know. You know, he's like 78 in human years. He bounds out of his crate and gives me this look that says, "Today is the best day in the entire year." And what's funny is he did that yesterday and the day before that and the day before that. In a lot of ways, he also reminds me of the preschoolers when we work together. Doesn't matter what day of the year it is, but if we've all gathered together for prayer, today is quite possibly the best day of the entire year. There's something about the creatures that we're surrounded with that helps us to understand exactly what it's like to live in the moment, fully alive and fully aware of just right now, which is something akin to understanding what it's like to be in God's kingdom, where everything is okay. There is no worry. There is just the love of the present moment. I find it really interesting that Jesus gives two very different examples to his friends about two things that do not worry. One are the beautiful flowers of the field, the lilies that grow up, that flower without even trying. How much time do we waste on trying to look nice, right? And yet they do it without even trying. Why? Because they simply are who they are. And I think it's kind of funny that he compares the lilies to Solomon, who was known for his expensive wardrobe, his expensive sense of decoration. And what you might be missing in this text is that when Herod the Great came to power, he decided that one way he would show the world how truly great he was to copy Solomon's style, fashion, and home decor, even though it was 400 years out of style. He thought that that would be a way he could show the world just how great he was. And so I often wonder when Jesus lifts up Solomon if he's not also giving a dig to the Herod family and their audacious sense of style. But the flowers simply bloom because that's the way God made them. What's even more wild is that he lifts up the ravens. Now, have you ever heard a raven cry? It is terrifying. The first time I ever heard a raven cry, I was at Camp Calumet on retreat. And I didn't realize that a flock of ravens was passing through and had taken up residence for the week. Now, ravens make a bunch of different sounds, but one of the sounds they make is the sound that is identical to a woman screaming for her life. Just like that. It is terrifying to wake up to that. to sit straight up in bed and wonder if someone's being murdered outside. However, Jesus points to these scavengers who are just as likely to pick something dead up off the road as they are to steal a shiny bit of tinsel, and says, look at how God cares for them. If God can care for all of these creatures, then surely God can care for you and me. Can care for us through our worry, can care for us through the difficulties that surround us, can care for us even when we don't know how to pray or what to ask for. Indeed, we are invited to strive after the kingdom, to strive after that faith that says that as we rise from our bed, that if God has brought us today into this new day, then this is in fact the best day ever, because this is the one we have right now. Tomorrow is a figment of our imagination, and yesterday is, well, maybe in our journal. Maybe we have some pictures to testify that it happened, but it's over. Today is what we have. So should we not spring into this day, rejoicing that this is a day that God has made, rejoicing that in this day there's the opportunity to give and receive love, just as the creatures in our lives give and receive love, and to rejoice that we can be with one another, having been stitched together as a new and wonderful family through the gift that Christ has given. Let us rejoice this day that God chooses to give us good things, and also that we have been given permission to be here, now, in the presence of each other and of God, so that we might celebrate every good thing that He has done. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Gracious God, in your love, you created us in your image and made us stewards of the animals that live in the skies, the earth, and the sea. Bless us in our care for our pets and animals. Help us to recognize your power and wisdom in the variety of creatures that live in our world, and hear our prayer for all that suffer overwork, hunger, and ill treatment. Protect your creatures and guard them from all evil, now and forever. Amen.
fun. Some sing higher, some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands or balls or anything they got now. It's a simple song, a little song everywhere, by the ox and the fox and the grizzly bear, the dopey alligator and the hawk above, the sly old weasel and the turtle dove. All God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands or paws or anything they got. All God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands or paws or anything they got. All God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands or paws or anything they got now. All God's creatures got a place in the choir.
Now let us join with the whole church to profess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Drawn together in the compassion of God, we pray for the church, the world, and all those in need. Holy God, you call us to work for peace and justice in your vineyard. Refresh the church with your life that we may bear fruit through work and service. Lord, in your mercy. Thank you for the abundant harvest of the earth. Bless and care for those whose hands bring the fruits of the earth to the tables of all who hunger. May we be inspired by your servants who care deeply for your creation. Lord, in your mercy. Curb the impulses of greed and pride that lead us to take advantage of others. Grant that all world leaders seek fruits of the kingdom for the good and welfare of all people. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for all those afflicted by COVID. We pray for their families who are affected by COVID. And we pray for those who have succumbed to COVID. Lord, in your mercy. Sustain all who suffer with the promise of new life. Assured of your presence, heal our pain and suffering. And equip us to embrace all bodies aching for wholeness of mind, body, and soul. We call to mind those who are struggling today, especially Judy and Gary Gibb, Fred Goebel, Fran, Lori Himes, Ed and Betty McCormick, Dave Allaire, Lisa Sears, Mary Goebel, Rain Briella, Tyler Corson, Betty McDermott, and those we name aloud or hold in our hearts. We send prayers of thanksgiving for your healing power and our many blessings. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for all managers in our community and for all who seek employment. Give hope and future to those who lack meaningful work. Those who have been marginalized or abused in the workplace, and those who desire new opportunities. Lead us in giving aid to those who are addicted and homeless. Help us to see your face in them and show us ways to bring comfort to them. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for family, for our church families, and this month we pray for the Sutherlands, the Tobins, Elsa Tower, the Tuckermans, Renee Warren, Ern West, and Crystal Wiedemann. And for our Little Lambs family of teachers and students, this month we pray for Kristen and the pre-K students, Jackson, Griffin, Cooper, Jacob, Brantley, Lydia, Grayson, Noah, Abigail, and Cooper. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for those who cannot be here with us today, including the homebound, Millie Lane, Kathy Lengel, Alex Pritchard, Ron Painter, Eleanor Zawatowski, and Carol LaRosa. And for our brave men and women in the military, Faustin Serrell, Jordan Hill, Brent Jaquith, Nathan and Michelle Kakoski, Kyle McCurrier, Michael Moyer, Shane Moyer, Jacob Dio, Zachary Schaefer, and Mika Garland. Thank you for those who return home safely. Show us how to provide them care and understanding, and comfort those who grieve, and gather around you those who have died. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for those who grieve, especially the family and friends of Betty Rapinski Smith, the sister of Bob. Thank you for all the saints who teach us to live faithfully in your vineyard. May our course join theirs until our labor is complete. Lord, in your mercy.
Listen as we call on you, O God, and enfold in your loving arms all for whom we pray. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
Also with you.
Let us share a sign of peace with one another. Our thoughts and hearts for prayer as we set the Lord's table. Let us also gather our gifts in thanksgiving to God.
All you have made is good, and your love endures forever. You bring forth bread from the earth and fruit from the vine. Nourish us with these gifts, that we might be for the world signs of your gracious presence in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. By the way, in us to run the race set before us, that we may delight in your mercy and rejoice with them in glory. And so with Francis and all the saints, with the choirs of angels and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. of power and might. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to all of them to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, we pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come to the banquet table where Christ gives himself as food and drink. This is the body of Christ given for you. And the blood of Christ shed for you. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, gracious God, that you once again fed us with food beyond compare, the body and blood of Christ. Lead us from this place, nourished and forgiven, into your beloved vineyard to wipe away the tears of all who hunger and thirst. Guided by the example of the same Jesus Christ and led by the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace. Of quick announcements. If you haven't taken the opportunity to reserve a spot for worship for the rest of the month, the table by the main entrance to the church does have the clipboards out. Please look at them carefully. Half of them are for Saturday night and half are for Sunday morning. If you signed up for one or the other, guess when you're going to church, okay? We actually have spaces available, not as many on Sunday, but we do have some spaces available on our Sundays and a number of spaces available still on Saturday night. And so if you want to go ahead and put those reservations in, the spot number one and spot number two are two people from the same household. And so that's who you can sit with. Otherwise, if you're coming alone, please put yourself in a new cluster of number one and number two. If you have any other questions, we're sure we'll be happy to help clear that up. Also, the Worship and Music Committee is going to stay after worship briefly to help clean up some of the odds and ends that we've been using all summer long. I think that God deserves a standing ovation for the incredible backdrop that has been provided for us for our worship. This is pretty awesome. Are there any other announcements that we need to share? Hey, look at that. It's a new month. It's not March anymore. That's because we're celebrating. Let's see. We're celebrating with Barbara, Carla, Rebecca, Mark, Michael, Sally, Dennis, Connie, Andrew, Marjorie, Kyle, Martha, Kara, Erwin, and Ethan. And any other October birthdays that I missed?
No, but I had an anniversary.
Oh, well, happy anniversary.
October 2nd was the first day I officially became...
Well,
director.
You're here. All right.
What a year.
What a year. Any other announcements? No? All right.
Go in peace. Pause to look at God's beauty and always remember the poor. Thanks be to God. Thank you.